Pupil of Narottam Das Thakur. Like Loknath Maharaj refused him to give this initiation, then Loknath Maharaj performed such a menial service that his Gurudev had met as he gave him initiation. Similarly, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he adopted such a path that his Gurudev was bound to melt. He stopped eating anything. And when Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur went to Gaurakeshwar Babaji Maharaj that, "Are you so much strong and hard-hearted? Look, this boy will not live, he will die." And when this thing, he was recommended by Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur like this, then he gave him initiation. He also narrated two pastimes, frankly which I could not get fully, Maharaj had explained it. One pastime was,
your house has, and then
I would also have a desire to have such house. Why should I go there? If you want to know anything, you should come here. Then he gradually said, many times he has said this thing. You want to tell the story of your self-gratification taking me to your house, or you want to show the story of light helicopter and self-gratification at your house? Once upon a time, there was a person, he used to come to Godhead with us, Babaji Maharaj, and always used to say, Babaji Maharaj, I want your mercy. And Babaji Maharaj used to instruct him, go on doing your bhajan. But again and again he was coming and saying, oh, I want your special mercy. Then he hold his hand, you want my special mercy today, I am ready to give you a special mercy. But you have to accept it. He just gave his door open to him. Have it by special mercy. Don't need to go in the hell of your homely life. But that meant rain away. Yes? These were the past times generated by Kutpa Maharaj. Sri Gopishan Bhaji Maharaj, why? When he was performing his bhajan, for Vishwadas Bhavaji Maharaj, At that time, so many people used to come to him. Many rich people, many money-minded, so many people were motivated with material desire to ask for his mercy. Rather, he became irritated by all these things. He said, these people don't let me do my bhajan. So, what he did, then very quietly, without informing anyone, one day he disappeared from that place and went into the local public municipal library and locked himself there and started performing his bhajan. The people came and they did not find Babaji Maharaj. Where he has gone? Where he has gone? They tried to find him out everywhere, but he was missing. Finally, they came to know that he has locked himself in the library and he is doing his bhajan. He said, people said, Babaji, please come out of it. Why are you performing your bhajan here in Latin? You must be knowing that Indian municipal Latin, how much foul smell they have. You must be having foul smell. He said, this smell is less than the smell of the materialistic people when they come to me.
So I think it is better to adopt this aristocratic dress because it is better than that.
it has nowadays. So, at the time, when we are observing his disappearance ceremony, we should pay our obeisances at his lotus feet, our pushpanjali to him, so that he may shower his causeless mercy on us. God Premanande.
But he came back, he could not stay there.
Because when he came back, he said, gopis are feeling such a high class of separation and pain. Because of separation, he could not bear that, he could not tolerate that. Still, he had become a blade of grass at Udhavud and trying to attain that bhava, but he is not getting that bhava because his constitutional position is like, not like that. Similarly, Yashoda, mother Yashoda, she is mother of Krishna. She loves her like mother. She is supporting and she is giving some push in Madhurya Bhav, but she is not ready to, or she cannot adopt that bhav in herself because her constitutional position is to remain as mother of Krishna. These all things have been given to us by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We are so much indebted to him. They were further given to us by Srila Rupa Goswami. And then in our dhara we got it. So easily we are coming to understand and to know all these things, which is so much difficult. How much difficult that Lakshmi also had to perform so much austerity, still she could not get. How come it is possible that we are listening all these things? Maharaj is again here telling that positively we must have some very, very strong impression of our past life. That is why we are able to come in this line. The line which is even the topmost thing. Because the service rendered by Gopi to Krishna, the mood which we are hearing it is so much high that it is not possible to even hear by ordinary persons. This is the characteristic of this dhara in which we have come because of our impression of our past life. When we came here, Maharaj is giving here a step. We came here, we attended all these classes and all these discourses and katha in the neutral form. We don't have any inclination towards any constitutional position. Still, we are hearing these classes and katha from the neutral part, and becoming neutral, then gradually some greed is coming into our heart. And hence, first we will perform our Vaidhi Bhakti from Vaidhi Bhakti while we continuously hearing such pastimes from such a high class rustic Vaishnava, then some greed will come in us. We will shift from Vaidhi Bhakti to Raghuruva Bhakti. This is the process. And when some greed comes, this means we are so much fortunate. We should not stop at this juncture. We should go ahead. So many others are there. We have cultivated some greed, but we have to try our level best to remove all these anartha, unwanted desire. If they will stay with us, then life together we won't get anything. How can we remove these unwanted desires and anartha? By associating, by keep on associating closely with such a high class Vaishnava and performing our bhajan, in their direct instruction and guidance we will be able to remove our anartha and we will progress by leaps and bounds. Gaur Premanate. Then Pujyapatri Vikram Maharaj, he has come out with a very another, what should I say, puzzle. He is saying, Krishna himself came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to taste the love of Radharani. Love of Radharani is so much high class that Krishna, who is himself the supreme personality of Godhead, could not understand it himself. So he had to adopt it another role. He took heart of Radharani and her complexion and then came, and he became the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to understand the extent of her love, the taste she relishes because of her love. Radharani's love is such a high class of love. And we conditioned soul, is it any possibility for us to taste that love at all? When Krishna himself has to do so much exertion for it, how come that we can get it so easily? It's not so easy. Then he has quoted one verse, Ashlashi Padartam. In this verse, he is saying, this is the prayer of Radharani. What she is saying? This prayer does not say that she is praying to, rendering her prayer to a person who is asking for her feet. No. Rather, she herself is saying that I always remain at your lotus feet, O Krishna. I am servant of your lotus feet forever. And I want to please you. I love you. So you may embrace me or put me in dust. It's your sweet will. But I always want to remain in your service. So this is the position of Radharani. Contradicting the yesterday's conclusion that Krishna always wants that Radharani's feet should remain on his head. So he is contradicting this statement and saying that Radharani's desire is always to remain at the lotus feet of Krishna. Therefore, we should understand the factual position. I beg mercy from Maharaj. He has spoken so deep today. Maharaj is reconciling the statement of which Vaishnava gave from Maharaj. He said, it is correct, it is true, that this is the mood of Radharani. What is her mood? That she says, whether either you embrace me or you just put me under your feet or tear down,
crush me
under your feet. Either you embrace me or crush me under your feet. Or you may go with other women. I will not mind, because you are my prana. I will always serve you. This is the mode of Radharani. But one thing we have to understand, because of this mood only, because of this extent of love only, Krishna has sold himself at her lotus feet. Krishna has sold himself at her lotus feet. This is the thing to be understood. Why Krishna is always desiring to serve the lotus feet of Radharani? Because she has this mood. What is the characteristic of Radharani? She is ready to sacrifice her millions of life and millions of prana at the glow of Krishna's lotus feet, nails, glow. She is ready to sacrifice her millions of lives. This is the inner, intense mood of Radharani, which has to be understood. Only because of her this mood, Krishna is loving her so much that he wants to serve her lotus feet. Now this verse, Ashra Shiva Father, recited by Radharani, shows her intense love and her intense desire also. It starts with Ashilashi. Ashilashi means to embrace. Her
Ashilashi.
Ashilashi. This verse starts from this word, Ashilashi. What does it mean? This means to embrace. Her first and foremost desire is to get Krishna's embrace. But if Krishna is not doing this thing, okay, then still she is ready to do all other things and render her service to Krishna as much as possible. But her first and foremost desire is this. So, what is her desire? To render her service. What way? Now again, Maharaj, how quickly and
attemptly, I will say, taking this subject matter to our subject matter of the Naam Roop Charitra, he is coming to this verse, that we have to adopt this mood by cultivating this process. But we should live in breath, we should always chant the name of Krishna, his pastimes, his characteristics, the Naam Roop Charitra. Now Maharaj is saying, Krishna is ek ras. In this connection, one thing he has also stated, that the Pujpatri Vikram Maharaj said that Krishna has come himself in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When Krishna had to do so much exertion and endeavor to understand Radharani's mood, how we living entity can do it. Of course, conditioned soul, it is impossible to understand the mood of Radharani. And it is very difficult to get her mood to some extent and serve. But with the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the mercy of Rupa Goswami, Srila Rupa Goswami, it has become easy for us to enter into this Raga Bhakti. This is because of their mercy only, not because of our conditioned state. Krishna is ek ras and bahu ras. Maharaj is explaining this thing, and I will try to translate as I could understand. What does it mean by ek ras? Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has very clearly stated all these things in his Jaya Dharma. Maharaj is saying that Jaya Dharma is a complete scripture. It contains everything. If one goes and undergoes this Jaya Dharma, he will know everything. He has not left. It is A to Z. Bhakti Granth. So, he is explaining that Krishna is ek ras. He is vishay of all the ras, but still he is ek ras. Maharaj is explaining. Radharani has got so many moods, so many different feelings in her heart. Krishna relishes it. The important point. All the moods of Radharani which she is having for Krishna, Krishna relishes it, but her mood of serving, and by her service, what she relishes, Krishna does not relish that. He does not taste that mood. The mood of Radharani is tasted by Krishna, but what Radharani is tasting her mood, while rendering her service, this Krishna cannot taste. And all, there are so many moods, different moods. All moods are tasted by Krishna. So he is ek rasa, rato vesa. In order to enjoy the mood of Radharani, when she serves, and in order to enjoy, to taste the enjoyment of Radharani, which she receives while serving, he has to acquire the mood of Radharani. Therefore, he came in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He took her mood, her complexion, and he came in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because that mood which Radharani relishes is called Ashray Tattva. And he adopted Ashray Tattva. What about living entities? Living entities does not have the mood of Radharani. It is very fractional. Living entities are very fractional. So it has got only partial, very small and partial mood in itself. But it can acquire to that extent by the mercy of Srila Rupa Goswami. How it is possible? Again, Jeev, living entity, he has got this constitution. position which he can acquire by adopting the process of the Naam Roop Charitra. This already explained by Srila Rupa Swami. Now, Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, in his commentary, he has explained this in the explanation of Srila Prabhupada Maharaj has given, it is very much enlightening. He says, sadhak in his life, when he intends to advance in Krishna consciousness, he starts with shravan.
This is called Shri Yudhishthira Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur.
Who is the name?
Shri Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur.
Who is quoting? Swami Narayan is quoting.
No. He's not got that book.
He has the book here.
Destruction.
Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, in his Metta Instruction commentary on Shivpada Samrita of Rupa Goswami Pad, he is quoting from the commentary of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur.
Next page.
Transcendental form, qualities and pastimes, one can attain to the stage of acceptance, which is called Varandasha. When one attains this stage, he becomes attached to hearing Krishna Katha. When one is able to chant in ecstasy, he attains the stage called Smaranavasa, the stage of remembering. Recollection, absorption, meditation, constant remembrance, and trance are the five items of progressive Krishna Smarana. At first, remembrance of Krishna may be interrupted at intervals, but later remembrance proceeds uninterrupted. The first stage is called Smarana. When remembrance is uninterrupted and becomes concentrated, it is called meditation. When meditation expands and becomes constant, it is called anusmriti. By uninterrupted and unceasing anusmriti, one enters the stage of samadhi, or spiritual trance. After smaranasha, or samadhi, has fully developed, the soul comes to understand his original constitutional position. At that time, he can perfectly and clearly understand his eternal relationship with Krishna. Then that state is called Sampatidasha, the perfection of life.
Rest we will speak with evening class. Now, Jagannath Dev has mercifully sent Shabrasadu from today is Dwadashi, Paran. So, we can take Paran from Jagannath Prasad. Hare Krishna. जो भक्ति वाले जाना चाहते हैं वो आज अपना नाम लिखा दे क्लास के बाद, नहीं तो संभव नहीं हो पाएगा। वो लोग सोच रहे हैं कर जाएगा
और इसके बाद में यही राष्ट्र स्थली यहाँ से वहाँ तक का राष्ट्र स्थली है। दे आर वेरी फॉर्चुनेट टू कम टू दिस प्लेस, दिस इज कॉल्ड जमुना। वेयर कृष्ण यूज टू सीट विथ ऑल हिज कवर्ड बॉय एंड यू टू टेक prasadam here, sent by their mother in Jamuna. And also Krishna did Raj with all the gopis, a very long place. Unlimited gopis used to be with Krishna and dons and Shiva. This is Jamuna. Yes, all the gopis in separation mood, they Tabakathamritam, Tapura Jivanam, all these places are. So we are fortunate. I think it would be better that we should be in lines and we should see in line, and Krishna is sending us very high class of prasadam here and prasadam here, and after that you should cross. You can go to
Let's be able to hear things now.